Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Photoshop. In today's tutorial, we'll see how to create this really cool glued photo effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. So let's go and open Photoshop, and as you can see, I already set up a document which is just like 3000 pixels for the width, 4500 pixels for the height, 300 in the resolution. Alright, so the first thing that we are going to do is to create a background. We are going to use gradient to do that, so let's go to this adjustment icon and choose gradient. And for the gradients, I already have 4 gradients that we are going to use for this tutorial. I will make sure to upload this in the link down in the description below. So this first gradient, it will be our background. So we select it and I will keep everything in here set the same and I will press OK. All right, let me just delete this background and this layer mask. And let's call this PG for background. All right, next we are going to our folder. And as you can see, we have in here a small halftone and a large halftone. I mean, I will make sure to upload all these 3 textures to in the link from the description below. You can either use the small one or the large one. So I will use the small one for now. And I will one click on this check mark. And the difference between them is the point of the halftone. The other one is a little bit larger. And that's all. Alright, now we'll right click and choose rasterize layer for the size of the document. Alright, next I will create a new layer on top of this halftone and I will call this image. And then I will right click on this image and choose convert to smart object. Now I will right click again and choose edit content. And here we are going to paste our image. As you can see, it's opening a new document or a new tab in Photoshop. Alright, so let's go back to our folder, and for me it will be this image, so I will drag it and open it in the smart object. And then I will size it to fit the document, something like that. Alright, and I will one click on this check mark. Now we need to cut the model from the background, so I will go to select and choose subject. And I will wait for it to calculate. As you can see, we have our selection. It's a very decent selection for me. I think this is good, so I will one click on this layer mask and this will apply the selection. Now we'll just close these smart objects and I will make sure to press yes to save our changes, which is our image. And then we're gonna make a copy of this image by pressing Ctrl Command J, and this will duplicate it. And then I will rename this to lines and I will rename this to effect. Alright, so for now I will select the line image and I will hide it and I will go back to this effect in here. So the first thing that I want to apply is a shadow and highlight, so I will go to image adjustment and choose shadows and highlight. Alright, so I want to the shadows to be more or to be less actually, so I will put the shadows up to like 70%. And the tone, I will keep them 50 and 30 for the radius. And for the highlights, I will keep it 0 and the tone to 0, everything to 0 in here for the highlights. And for the adjustments, I'm gonna only change the colors to like minus 10 or 16, maybe minus 16. And I will press OK. And by the way, if you don't see all these options, make sure that show more options is in here is checked, so this way you can see all these options in here. All right, so I'm gonna press OK. All right, next we're gonna apply a filter, so let's go to filter and choose filter galleries. And the filter that we are going to apply is in the artistic folder, which is called cutouts. So I will make sure to select it. And for this cutouts, you need to experiment with it. It depends on your image or how you want your lines to be. So for me, I will maybe put the number of the levels to 7, and edge simplicity I will put it like 4, or maybe I will change the number of levels to 8, and for the edge simplicity I will put it like 4, and I will keep the edge fidelity set to 1, and I will press OK. Alright, so as you can see we already applied this, but it's a little bit rigid in here, so we need to smooth it a little bit. So what we're gonna do is to apply an oil paint filter. So let's go to filter, stylize, and choose oil paint. Alright, for this also you need to experiment with it for how strong you want it, but for me I would keep the stylization set to 3, 10 in the cleanness, and 0.1 in the scale, and also 3 for the pistol detail, and I will make sure that lighting is off, and I will press OK. Alright, the last thing that I want to apply for this effect layer is a drop shadow in the edge in here. So I will go to this FX icon and choose blending options, and down in here I will select the drop shadow, and the first thing that we are going to do is to change the color. I want it to be 50% gray. So for example, if you have it in red, you can just go to this white, change it to white, and then in this brightness in here put 50%, and this will change it to 50% gray, and press OK. Alright, so I will keep the blending mode set to normal and opacity to 60%, and uncheck use global light. And for the spread, make sure that it's set to 0 and 0 pixels for the size. And for the distance, you can actually use your cursor to choose where you want to put this. So for me, I think I will put it just somewhere around here. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks nice. Maybe a little bit down. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks nice. And maybe I will keep 5% in the noise too, and I will press OK. Alright, so we're done with everything about this effect layer. So let's go back to the line layer and make it visible. And again, I want to apply shadows and highlights. So I will go to image, adjustments, and choose shadows and highlights. For this, I will put 0% for the shadows amount and 0% for the tone. But for the highlight, this time I will put 100, and for the tone 100. Just want it to be a little bit darker, only the highlights in here that I want. So something like that, and I will press OK. And let me delete the smart filter. Alright, now we'll go back to filter, and again filter gallery. And this time we're gonna go to stylize and choose glowing edge. So this one that we're gonna turn to have them as lines, as you can see. Now also this one you need to experiment with it. It depends of how strong the lines you want them to be. For me, I would keep the edge width to like 4, and the brightness is depend on how bright you want everything. As you can see, the more brighter, the more details will show. So I don't recommend to go that high, maybe like 3 or 4, and maybe I will put down the width to like 2 or 3. Yeah, let's keep it 3. But for the smoothness I will keep it 15, because I want the lines to be smooth, and I will press OK. Alright, as you can see, everything in here turns black, which means we can use the blending mode to change this into highlights in here. So to do that, we're gonna choose one of this light mode in here. It can be lighting or screen, but for me I think I will go with color touch, because I think it looks really nice with the color touch in here. Alright, so we are done with our effects for both of them, and now we're gonna apply some color on top of everything using gradients map. So let's go to adjustments again and choose gradients map, and again the gradient that we are going to use is from this 4 in here. So for me, I'm gonna use the second one, but you know, feel free to choose whatever one. All of them are really nice, as you can see, a very different look, but let's go for this one for now and press OK. And as you can see, we have a really nice color and lights, as you can see. Alright, so the last thing that we are going to apply on top of this is this glue texture. So we'll take it and drag it. So open it in here and one click on this check mark. And then I will right click and choose rasterize layer. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J to duplicate it. And let's call this highlight. And let's call this one shadow. Alright, so let's hide the highlight texture for now and select the shadow texture. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to multiply. And that's what we are going to do for these shadows. But for the highlights, we're gonna make it visible. And we're gonna change the blending mode of this to screen. And as you can see, because our texture is already white, it won't work with this blending mode. So we need to make it darker for it to have highlights on these wrinkles in here. But you might think we need only to invert it, but it won't work if we invert it. So the trick is to actually press Ctrl Command L to open the level adjustment and to dark it from these tones in here. So I will take this point in here of the black, and I will put it more to put more black into the image until we see only this highlight in here, as you can see. So something like that. But as you can see, it's a little bit really strong. And for us to fix that, we're gonna play with this output level of the dark and the white. So we'll take this white point and put it into the left until it's less heavy, as you can see, something like this. Yeah, I think something like this, it will work for me, and I will press OK. And there we go, we have our effects. And if you think it's strong, you can always go back and put down the opacity a little bit. But for me, I think it looks really nice. Alright, and that would be our effects. As you can see, it looks very nice. And the good thing about this, because we use a smart object, you can always go back and double click on one of the smart objects and apply the same effects on any other image that you want. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial and this was a little bit helpful for you. If you try this, make sure to let me know on Instagram, Facebook, whatever. And don't forget to subscribe and comment and leave a like. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.